they've already banned out the Venomancer and the Brewmaster. And they're going to be going into their first pick now. Trollwarden and Juggernaut being banned out for the Radiant Venge being the first pick up here. What do you think about the ban so far? Venomancer being the first ban.
That's kind of weird. But yeah. People are... I get Troll and Juggernaut.
Troll, Jugger, really, Brewmaster.
Yeah, Juggernaut, people are very tired of playing against him.
Very true, very true. But Venomancer, I don't know. The people rate that hero pretty differently, and... I don't know about first ban worthy, unless, for all I know, there could be a great Venomancer on the Radiant team. No. But it's not one of those heroes you see everyone... Lion. One of those heroes that... I think it's got so much utility. Even like late game, a blink into Hex has got so much value. And it's just so good with the hero.
It's good like at all stages of the game. I think it's weird to pick Zeus so early, because he's probably going to go mid. Mm. And you can kind of counter that quite easily with heavy ganks on him. People also banning Brutmar. That hero is... I think Brutmar is one of the worst heroes in Dota at the moment.
Really? That's interesting to say. There's some different thoughts about it, but...
No, but actually, with worst, like, not she's the weakest, but she's the most broken hero.
Oh, I see what you mean. Right, okay, fair enough.
Worst designed hero.
Oh, okay, right, West Side hero. Well, fair enough. They do ban out the Slippery Fish, which is Slark as well, known by many, well, hated by many, really. And, yeah, like, as you were saying, Broodmother, what would you say about her, then, that you just hate as the core concept of the hero?
The problem with Broodmother is that every time I see her in my games, it's going to be the last pick. So if they pick Broodmother against our team, and we don't really have any hero who's good against it, like Axe or Legion Commander or Tidehunter, then we just straight out lose the game right there. She can go solo off lane, and then she can shut down a tri lane with two supports and one carry, and she can just shut them down and kill them, and you can't do anything. It's so broken.
Yeah, it is infuriating. I think you're completely right to say that if you don't have the right heroes, the right tool set to deal with it, you do just get steamrolled by her, and it's crazy.
If you have X against Brutmana, she's just not gonna do anything. So either she will do a lot, or else she will pretty much do nothing. And she can't really leave the lane or go gank or go anywhere else because of her webs, how they work. She can't just go in this and try to gank mid. She can't just place a web mid and try gank. It's just doesn't work in that.
Yeah, no. I agree. They tried to, when they changed it so that you can have charge of the webs, and there's a little bit more flexibility with how she works, but Tidehunter now picked up for the Radiant. Another stable hero, like, very very good at being able to just help out these teamfights. They've now got the Zeus for the damage, Lion to have some control, and Tidehunter to just control the teamfights, and Rubick now gets picked up, which, again, is great if they've got this teamfight control. It's good to have the Rubick on your side, but it's a hard
they're
hero.
They're saving their main carries. I like that they just pick supports in the beginning.
Yeah,
I could try to try to fix my mic if it's still having a bit problems sometimes. Well,
it's strange. Like right now, when you say that, it's absolutely fine. But when you were discussing Broodmother earlier, it was crackling a lot. I'll check the chat. Is the microphone is still? Yeah, I had a couple of people say it's crackly, but yeah. Well, I'll let you know if it happens again. I'm not sure if it's just. It sounds like just lag, but it could just be Skype. I don't really use Skype that much for voice, so. I'm not sure. Let me know if you... PA now picked up for the Radiant. And let me know if you have any luck with fixing your microphone. I can't hear you at the moment. I'm assuming you muted it to test it.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Ah, I can hear you, yeah.
Okay. So I tried to... Maybe that may be a bit background noise at the moment. Maybe a bit, but I removed the post-processing.
Sure, sounds absolutely fine at the moment. I'll let you know if there's any issues with it, though.
Yeah, tell me if it's still lagging and stuff like that, then I can keep fixing it.
And yeah, guys, this is a very very rough test at the moment of... I'm still not used to really casting with a co-caster, so my apologies if I speak over you at any point, Slasher. Feel free to just speak and I'll try and make space. The trouble is, I love the sound of my own voice, so I'll just keep speaking. Alright, so what sort of carry do you reckon the dyes should pick up here? PA now being picked up for the Radiant.
Okay, one second. My mic isn't working on stream. You can hear me, but... They get PA now on the Radiant. So that's going to be safe lane PA and then Zeus mid, and they take Invoker against that mid.
Nice to see. Invoker, what are your thoughts on the hero? Obviously, You could do a lot. So it's quite crazy to see that they would take. I don't know. I think that having Rubick can be shut down very easily. Obviously, they've got really. He's got a lot of spells he could steal, but it's hard to get the items. Like, I think he needs at least a Blink Dagger or Four Staff with Arcanes, or else he can't really do much in the fight. I really do like Rubick, though.
I think right now with Rubick, I guess you just stay back and wait for the Tidehunter. So I guess he pretty much just needs Arcane's Boots to just spam spells. And I think Blink Dagger and all things like that, it's just kind of luxury.
So you think it's not so much needed as, like you say, as long as good positioning and smart
Yeah,
plays around the team fight, he can still
as
make
long
work.
as you can just wait back and wait for the Tidehunter, as long as your team's strong enough, because Bad Rat is just going to grab someone, and then Tide kind of has to initiate on that. And then Ruby can steal it afterwards.
No, very true. Animage being banned out and Omni Knight for the Dire banned.
One sec, I'll try to fix the mic because they can't hear it on my stream.
Oh, sure. So, oh, what? So they could hear me and not you? Oh, that's weird.
Yeah.
I guess it's something to do with the. So, was it just some software you turned off? Because it might be something to do with the microphone you've got set to Twitch being
Yeah, I'm
the
looking
running
at
through the
it up.
software.
I may have to restart the stream, I'll just look at it.
Right, sure.
Seconds remaining.
Well, I'll let you go through that. Whilst Sand King being the last pickup for
Dire
the
team
Radiant
incoming.
there. So the team's come together now. They've got a lot of magical damage on the Radiant, and it's gonna be hard for them to really hold their ground. Like Rubick will probably die in a lot of the crossfire if he does get caught in a Ravage with the Zeus ulti. Veg could obviously do some pretty crutch swaps, and we got the Batrider to lasso and catch the PA out. But still, it's going to be hard work. Zeus should be ganked quite a lot middle if they get the rotations through.
Microphone test? Okay. I have microphone. I have audio on my stream. Sorry about
Hey,
the
brilliant. That's good. No,
interruption
no, no,
there.
no problem. This is the test you want to do. So that's all right.
Reserve time.
Okay, let me just check my settings as well. So my camera settings may or may not work this game. Ah, oh, fuck it, it'll be fine.
Be sure to tell me if you have any problems with clipping and stuff like that again.
No, sure, yeah. At the moment, it's been absolutely fine, but
Okay.
it was weird before. It was okay, and
Yeah.
then suddenly it would come in and
I
out.
had like post-processing, so that's probably why
Right,
it's
sure. Okay, and the last pick for the Dire still hasn't been picked up yet. What sort of hit? And there we go,
Spectre.
Spectre.
I like that pickup. They're just gonna go in with Batrider, grab someone. And then they cause a Spectre ult, and then Tide gonna reinitiate, and then they can steal Tide ult easily. Ruby's gonna have so much vision.
Very nice. Well, I'll quickly run through the Radiant then, and I'll let you do the Dire. So on the Radiant, we do see
Prepare
Elboy on the
for
Tidehunter, who's going to be taking the off lane. We do see Real Axe on the Zeus going middle. Gold on the ceiling on the Lion. He's going to be taking a support role, and Sand King going bot. That's Fohu, and Soulai on the PA taking the safe lane.
And we have Kefka on the Batrider going off lane, Jujitsu on Rubick going against support, and Kick'Octopus on Invoker going mid, and Meerbot on Vengeful going support safe lane. You know, also has smoke in the beginning, and then we have Cytrus on Spectre going farming top.
So, in case you know, like, if you look at the video map now, you could see my
Ah,
camera move around.
sure.
So, yeah, I was following you then when you were going through those. So, it's quite nice.
Okay.
So, what do you think about these bounty runes here? It should be that Kefka should be able to get away from.
Yeah, he can. I don't think he won't contest. I think they're just gonna do it so Dire gets top and Raiden gets bottom bounty rune.
Okay, I'm not sure what this issue is. I've had this before, but have you selected Spectre at the moment? Because
No, I'm
okay,
just.
that's weird. Every time I go to change heroes, I can only see Spectre. Oh, now it's changed to Lion and Sand King. Okay, this is weird. Well, whatever. That's fine. It's probably something to do with my camera settings. So, as you said, the bounty runes went down. Dire took the top. Radiant at the bottom.
And they're gonna go tri lane, safe lane. Both guys are going safe lane, tri lane. And I guess they're gonna jungle with Sand King as well. So they're gonna have like kinda tri lane, but also jungling Sand King.
So who do you
So
think is really going to get more from this? Because as you said, Sand King could just go into the jungle, really farm up, whereas the
yeah.
Rubick and the Venge are going to be pretty starved up
So
top.
the Dire, they have to get the rotation and ganks to work. Because if they just stay passive here, then the Raiden are gonna do more and they're actually going a Batrider bottom.
Yeah, down bot. Again, the dagger off, and he's close. Goes to 84 HP. Did the Sun King actually land the stun there? I assume he did if he went that low.
Yeah, he must have landed it.
Yeah, and I did miss that bit there. Still, right, up top, they're not going for the kill yet, and they're just pulling and stacking. So
they're going to smoke for Zeus pretty soon. And if they just get close, there's pretty much nothing Zeus can do about it.
Yeah, he's one of those heroes that if he does get caught there, he's gonna pay the price. And this is really odd. I can't... What hero have you got selected at the moment?
So I'm just kind of going around, and right now I'm looking at Invoker. So I'm just...
So I'm not sure what this is, what setting this is, but every time you click on a hero, that's what my hero selection at the bottom is set to. But that's fine. I was just trying to work out why, when I was clicking on heroes, it wasn't showing their skills or anything.
I click bad rider right now.
Yeah. Okay, well, that's fine. At least I know what's going on. That works out well.
Sure, you can just say if you want to look at them.
Yeah, no, that's no problem. I can press F5 for inventories and stuff like that. So that works okay. So we do see the courier deliver to the Batrider. I think that was his just more tangos.
And Tide actually abandoning the offlane. Now checking the rune here, getting a double damage.
Batrider does get a bounty there, and as you said, Tide with the DD. So first blood potential, like you said, if they get a good smoke rotation onto mid, this Zeus is just going to be dead, and this is going to be what's going on right now. Did they miss the smoke on?
I'm not sure why they're not smoking Vengeful as well. Maybe it's too obvious. They actually blocked the Ancients, which is pretty good against Tide, so he won't just stack them.
That's very nice. And as you say,
he's actually trying to snipe the courier. I really like this solo snipe on the courier.
This could be big, especially if it's a bottle courier, as it is now. Oh, no.
That's huge. That's so huge.
This is going to be a disaster. Look, it waddle into the Rubik's arms, and that's a kill.
Well played.
Oh, Jiu-Jitsu doing work there, and Zeus is going to be livid that this has happened.
He's going to go now and going to punish him for it. I don't think he can kill him.
Yeah, Rubik is just like, oh, God, I'm going to have to walk around
it. Oh, he's dewarding.
At least he realizes about this and gets it through now. Rubik gets a couple little auto attacks just to annoy him, and Zeus is like, whatever, I'm going to finish this sentry.
I think he should almost have stayed there and just to block the 3 minutes spawn.
Or
maybe
just
hit the Zeus, because he was going to keep dewarding that.
Yeah, that's true. Just to disrupt him a little bit more. So Zeus is going to be really starved now. What would you say he has to do now that he's just lost his bottle? Just keep trying to... I suppose there's nothing really he can do.
He can stand in the lane as long as... He can at least get experience. And as long as he knows that they're pulling top, then he should be okay. But it's really not a nice position for him to be in. So what I do a lot is that when I'm mid... Can you see when I draw a map?
Yeah, I can see this.
So when I'm mid, I go with the courier and I send it like this way, and then to me, and then I send it the same way back again. Because if people snipe courier, they will always stand here. So especially against Furion, you have to send the courier like this way around and then to you.
Yeah, it just saves situations like that. Especially as soon as the ball was on the walking courier going back, you knew it was definitely going to die. And I have missed the first blood on the Rubik. Yeah,
I actually got the first blood top on Rubik.
I really didn't expect that to happen. No, I guess that was just... Oh, well, there is another stun going to be available on the Venge shortly, but Tide's still coming around. Lion's up here as well. Venge could be caught out. They've got the ability to turn to the stun shortly, but Tide, go for more. Oh, Lion misses the stun. That is a shame.
I'm not sure why he would stun first. He should just hex first, and then I guess stun isn't really longer range, so...
Venge walking straight into the Tide. Does get anger smashed up. Stun comes onto the Tide Hunter now. Going to take a lot of damage on the Venge, but at least they get back here. But this is the Batrider who's turned up, and there's the Sunshine that does miss, but Tide able to back out some more. And Batrider's invis, so he's just going to be able to walk away from it.
That is a long rotation, going all the way from offlane, then trying to get a kill and then not getting it either.
Yes, he's going to be in trouble now. I suppose he's just got to go into the woods, get his stack off, and just be happy with that.
This PA is going face boots. I really don't like that.
No.
I guess it's okay, but I prefer always going treads. I guess it's more like a personality thing.
Yeah, you do see some... Oh, and here we go, mid lane. Zeus again caught out. This is it. Gets Sunstrike, but he gets thrown back off the Sunstrike. That's two missed Sunstrikes now, but it's still okay. They get the kill, at least.
Did I hear it? It wasn't Invoker's fault that time. It was...
no, that's true. Rubik did throw him back off of it, so it was going to be a perfect Sunstrike to the kill. But at least they get it, so you can't complain too much about that. And last hit-wise... Invoker's leading the way. 35 last hits, 40 denies. Spectre then being the second, and PA on third. Zeus was obviously mana starved and had to rotate all the way back. He is... let's quickly check this. Yeah, so Sand King's just in the jungle now, killing his stack. So he's going to be able to get some gold here. We do see some TP rotations to middle, and
Zeus yeah, got his bottle back now, so
that's nice at least. Yeah, actually, not quite level 6 yet.
He's actually level 5 now, and Rubik is level 7, so I guess he got somewhat shut down in the middle. But at least, like, Pierre is free farming and has 35 last hits, and okay, Spectre's also
here we go, farm. Yeah, and up top, Rubik's in trouble. Lion got the haste, gotta be going for him. Got the Hex off. Lift comes back, throws it down, and Batrider's here. Only level 4, but Tidehunter has rotated around, so there's a little bit of a clash in the river. We do see that Venge is going pretty hard in here mid, but the Lion was blocked out on that with the haste, so he wasn't able to get around to stun off the Venge. Which is a shame to see. But at least none of them die there, I suppose.
Yeah. I hope that, you know, with PA, when you're level 11, you can pretty much solo Roshan, but I don't think he's going to do it in this game because they have a bad rider, so it's really risky.
Yeah, and if you threw away Rosh to the to the Dire, it could easily ball out of their control now. Yeah. Let me just press F5 because I can't share that. So with Spectre's items, what sort of thing do you want to see coming out from Spectre? He has obviously got 1.9k gold at the moment. So
I'd like to see Iron.
Yeah, you want to see the urn out? Well,
yeah.
Slash's way.
With Spectre, urn is pretty much always a good pickup. It looks like he may actually be rushing Radiance, which it really leaves your team not being able to do that much when you rush Radiance, and you're going to be really easy to gank. So I think if you're going to rush Radiance, I think you should at least maybe get Treads and Magic Stick before, so you're going to be able to fight.
Now, I do see the benefits out of this game, and at least if you got the Radiance, though, like, Lion is going to be struggling, PA as well. The burn is going to be quite nice on there, especially as you said, they haven't gone for Treads, so it's just that little bit extra, like, squishiness on the PA is going to make get caught out more. Rubik's taking the off lane here, trying to get some levels, but he could easily, yeah, here we go. PA sees the opportunity, goes in on him there. Lion tried to come in to get the stun, but isn't able to get it off, and PA with another dagger isn't getting the kill though, and it's very close, but Zeus.
It was actually pretty nice. Rubik was trying to go for him. Okay, Spectre coming in now. Where's he going to go?
Yeah, oh, Hex onto the Lion there down bot, keeps it away.
Just a passive ulti from Spectre not going in anywhere.
And Venge was run down by the Zeus.
Now Bad Rider's in trouble. Oh, you see?
Yeah, Dagger comes out here, and he should be able to back out. He's still got two bottle charges. So, the offlane there, Rubik was a little bit greedy and just dies to the Zeus ulti, but I thought he was going to just die to the PA jumping on him, so the fact that he survived that long, I suppose, is a bit of a miracle in itself.
I think it's kind of fine to, like, bait out Zeus ulti. He didn't really, he couldn't do anything. He was low, so He went in again, but Suicide is gonna hit him no matter what. It's actually pretty nice. He lifted PA back into Rubik, so Rubik couldn't stun him, and they had to. He forced the Suicide.
Ravage used up top. Tidehunter goes in on the Spectre. Has got Zeus to back him up, but Zeus pretty low on mana, and Spectre's just trying to run around the corner. As you said, very close. 13 HP, and wow. Zeus has got no mana left. But there's Gush. Right.
Well, if he had earned it, then
Earn and Treads, and he would have had just a little bit more HP to get out there. And there's the Sunstrike. Like, not quite. So Elboy gets away with it there.
That's the problem with doing like this almost Nick Rapier Radiant Spectre. He just so easy to kill. And now he's actually buying his Treads, so I guess he heard what we were saying.
Yeah, it's a case of balling out and just deciding, you know what, it's not worth my time here going for it. Sanking getting focused here. Batrider's trying to run him down with the Napalm. They're getting the stacks, but Sankey's going to be able to back out. So the smoke rotation hasn't done anything yet. Oh, we do have the urn. Urn and Treads, that is what you want to see. Yeah. And mid lane, this is going to be a Lion getting caught out here. If the smoke gets something, this is going to be worth it. And Lion's only level 4, and unless he gets a stun off, Zeus ulti has fallen through. This time, stunned. There's the Sunstrike. Perfect execution. And he gets over the
smoke. What do we have? 1 out of 4 Sunstrikes?
Yeah, that is...
We shouldn't be too tough on that move.
No, I mean, some of them, they have just been moving around, so it's some of the things where you can't get it off. And some of them have just been unlucky. Up top, what do we see here? Spectre again being pushed back by the Tide, just anchor smashing him out of the lane, but he's doing okay. He's not doing too bad.
So what Spectre really needs right now is to get a kill, so he gets 2 earned charges, and that would really help him just keep farming. Because right now, if the Tide just harasses him a little bit, then he kind of has to back up because he has no regen.
We do see that Invoker in the mid lane. He has got his they could make Midas. A fight here mid. Yeah, he has got his Midas and 1.8k gold on him. What sort of item do you want to see next coming out from him?
I think maybe Necronomicon would be pretty good.
just trying to force down the push and just trying to get these towers. I mean, they could take Roshan pretty easily with the remnants, I suppose. But then again, I suppose you don't want to commit that much time with Avenge and
They're
Invoke
going for
Beam.
Spectre top now with a double smoke.
Okay, this could be nice. But then again, the Dire are all
Oh,
here, but
counter it.
Spectre just a little bit caught out there. Isn't any finger off the lion, but he's getting stunned up. He's not going to need it. But then here comes Batrider to save the day. Not quite in time. Uses the
Buy
lasso
back the
there. Zeus
Spectre.
caught. Buy back into a triple kill. This will be well worth it. And yeah, Tide's going down as well. So it's a shame he dies there, especially with the team being that close. So I suppose it's just they were a little bit too far the wrong second there.
Yeah, I would say that it's a bit better for the Dire, I guess, but it's not really that good because
It's not ideal. You
Spectre's,
don't
but he
want to
got
have your core.
four enchanted, so I guess that's kind of nice.
Yeah, Sand King did have his Blink Dagger, and he was a little bit late to that fight, so Epicenter might have been enough to force something, I suppose, but no, not
Going on
quite.
Invoker mid. Not sure if they can catch him.
No. Sunshine being used. Hits the lion. He's going to get all tapped down, and he gets the kill
Wow, what a player.
beneath the tier 1. That was very nice.
He went a
Kick
Blink
off.
Dagger. That's interesting.
Yeah, and he should be able to get away if he could just sit here for 3 seconds, but no, not
Oh,
quite.
play wheel. Ah, he's
Oh.
dead, I think.
That was very close. I think he could have got
You
away
got
there,
one?
but
You got one?
yeah.
Okay, you just won.
Well, okay.
So this PA hasn't been involved at all in any of the fights, and he's rushing a Battle Fury, which I think is pretty weird. He doesn't need a Battle Fury in this game. I talked with a 7k PA player who pretty much only plays PA. And he told me that he only goes Battle Fury when he's against maybe CK or something like that.
Oh, see, so just where you are actually forced to have the cleave
Yeah,
to
it's
have the
for the
impact.
illusions.
Well, yeah, you see this where PA is just far up, and here we go up top again.
Spectre
Spectre is
dying
really
again.
paying the price.
Earn yourself.
Very close. Nearly able to go off, but that was a nice slip, but he's still dead.
PA going in now. He needs to. Okay, he doesn't have Ravage. They could turn it around.
Swap back, and that's the crit onto Rubick. He was going to die anyway, regardless of crit, I suppose. But Tidehunter are very low. I can't see Venge's cooldowns, but stun is available now. And oh, there we go. Able to disarm them both, but wasn't. Yeah, they're not going to be able to force down the line.
PA can't fight at all right now because the items she went. She has no item which gives her HP or any lifesteal. If she had went more like threats and then some lifesteal and something like that, she could just stay and pretty much get a triple kill maybe there.
Yeah, I agree. Like, having just the Perseverance as well as Phase means, especially you did have the stick, but still, it's, yeah, you take a little bit of damage and you're having to run away, especially big spells like the Invoker getting the Sunstrike off on you could be enough to just get you too low straight off the bat.
I think if you want to go Battle Fury, you should only pretty much only TP if they dive to tier 1 tower. Are you sure that you can at least get like 2 kills or something like that? Now she really needs to farm her Battle Fury and just get her farm up.
Yeah, no, very nice. So Lion is stacking the Ancients at least. So when she's got the Battle Fury, she's is going to be able to clear this stack, which is going to give them some sort of gold bonus. Let me quickly just check these graphs here. So expected, it is Dire's way, but it's only 1,500 gold, well slightly over 1,500 gold and 2,000 XP. So it's not the biggest lead, and it could easily go either way at a moment's notice. Like the Radiant, I would say have the team fight more, unless the Batrider gets a good lasso at the start of the fight, but
Yeah, Tide
hard to
getting
say.
a huge ancient stacks right now, which is gonna tip the gold back and I guess going equalize the gold a little.
Yeah, and this will lead to his Blink Dagger if he decides to go for it right now.
But they have shut down Spectre so much.
Yeah, there we go. There's the blink on Tide. And yeah, shutting down the Spectre, forcing a buyback, all this stuff, it really does add up. And Batrider just teched Roche, as you said,
Going for
when
PA
people.
now.
And there we go. PA's being lassoed back. Spectre comes down as well, wants to get that tasty gold. At least they killed the PA. So Punisher just sitting out here in the lane. And what did Rubick steal? It was Dagger, okay. Still pretty useful spell.
Yeah. Dagger is actually, that's pretty good. It's so low cooldown.
Yeah.
Doesn't cost pretty much no mana.
Yeah, especially with Rubick's mana pool. It's just, yeah, it could do the Punisher. And it's really great for just chasing them down. I think the only person we've got a keep an eye on now is the Sand King. Sand King could do a lot of work here. He's got his Blink, Epicenter. He hasn't really turned up to many fights yet.
The problem with Sand King is that it's going to be really hard to get a decent ulti off because when Spectre does his ulti, he's just going to reveal Sand King and he can't blink at all.
No, I agree. This is why I think Spectre, I think Sand King's got to take the initiative and try and go for it here. Baradam was scouted out by the Zusol. He has got his blink available in 3 seconds, so he
Sand King blinks into the trees, just...
Oh, no. Oh, dear, that's not what you want to see. Well, Batrider gets out for that. That's Sand King's still there, just hiding his shame in the tree line at the moment. And top lane, we do see Spectre still up here farming away. So, as you said, he went for treads. And what's the next item do you want to see out on the Spectre?
He should go with Radiance now. He's saving for Radiance now. And he should also have TP. And because PA is going this Battlefield build, he gets all the space in the world. PA needs a lot of time to come online now because this Battlefield. And Spectre's probably going to have his Radiance when PA gets online. So, it's... They could really punish the fact that Spectre has to go get a Radiance, and the supports have done that and they've ganked him, but the main carry is just kind of too far behind, I would say, almost.
So as you said, with PA rushing in the battlefield, do you think that top gank, which I suppose he did get a kill for it, but it wasted a lot of his time, Do you think stuff like that is just a waste when you go in this battlefield rush? You got to like do one thing or another, just commit for it?
If you go battlefield rush, as I said, you should really only TP if they dive your towers. Or if maybe it's 5v5, but they don't wanna. If you go a battlefield rush, your team, you don't wanna fight 5v5 at all, and it can be okay sometimes. Wow.
Lion gets the venge done through the trees, but
what a troll!
You venge almost just like, what
that
the
they had wards there.
Yeah, that is true. So that's venge is just like, well, I'm going all the way back then. So kind of saves his life, but they do know that the Radiant are walking through their woods, so they're being a little bit more careful there. There's a little bit of flame coming out there, Jesus Christ.
But the nice thing with Darren right now is that Spectre, he can just farm the jungle, and he's not doing that so much right now. I'm not sure where he's going.
No, I think he was going down to take the bot farm, but Zusol gets the site out and immediately earns himself back up on the Spectre. We do see Batrider just rotating back around as well. I think no one wants to sit in the jungle at the moment for the Dire because they were scared of what was happening top, but I think they should just try and maybe get a couple of catches. I suppose they don't know that Sand King is in their jungle along with the Lion, I mean in the Radiant jungle, this could be catches mid.
So Spectre is farming bottom because they're pushing top, and I think they can actually, like, Spectre wants his Radiance, but they could still fight right now.
Definitely. Him turning up for the fight with the Oli, like you said, it really got to disrupt the Sand King, and if the Sand King doesn't get a good epi because of it, it just comes down to the Ravage then.
PA, he needs a BKB as well to be able to fight.
Batrider catches the catch off here on the Sand King. This is a TP rotation, but Spectre's turned up as well. Sand King misses his stun, and Spectre was able to sneak him through the tree lines. No reveal on the Sand King.
He should end him again.
Yeah, oh no, he uses his Oli instead, and that should get the guard. There's the end.
Now then he gets two charges again, so it's just a free earned charge if you only have one left.
Yeah, there's a case where some people save the earned charge so much and it's not that effective, as you were saying. So just trying to keep that, maximizing the effectiveness of it. And Zeus has got to be caught here in the woods if Venge comes down. Gets the swap off, but the rest of his team isn't that close. There's the Sunstrike. Big plays there.
I actually really like what Spectre was doing. He used the ulti and earned Sand King and got the kill. And then I think he actually just transported mid with Horn and just kept farming mid. So he actually has his Sacred Relic right now.
And Batrider blinks in, immediately hexed by the Lion. Lion's got the stun available as well. Ravage overlapped on with the stun, but I suppose... Well, Ravage was used there. Batrider manages to die and doesn't finish off the Lion. And they've got to take a tier 1 for it.
This PA, I think I would almost try to go for a solo Roshan Smoke right now. It's really, really risky, but I feel like they are kind of behind, and Spectre's going to have his Radiance soon.
Yeah, they should be able to get it off, as you were saying. I can't see what's on the curry, I'm afraid, so I'm going to just check.
It's a Helm of Dominator, so he has...
The full Helm of the Dominator onto the PA now. So yeah, as you said, if they manage to just go and sneak the Roche, that could have quite a big effect on this next team fight. Sand King was focused down there very quickly, and although Rubick and Batrider both did die for kind of overextension down here bot, there was a case of Rubick was caught here, and it felt like they were so greedy for a Lion kill that they had to pay two deaths for it.
Yeah.
I suppose that does just happen, though. You get a little bit overconfident, you get a bit of a lead, and you start to throw it by being a bit ballsy or doing that all-in dive plays.
So what Dire is doing right now is they are about 400 gold away from the Radiant and Spectre, I mean, they get Radiance, they're just going to push before PA gets BKB, and they should be able to pretty easily just wipe out the entire team. So I think Radiance, they should just smoke up and try to catch Spectre before it gets to Radiance, but it's going to be pretty hard.
Yeah, this is taking it late game. What do you think about the Radiance odds? Because obviously there's always that buyback horn scary factor from the Spectre, and
yeah,
I suppose...
I think it's a bit tough to say exactly who's going to win late game.
No, yeah. Sure. Oh, Haunt there dodges the gank. So Spectre now comes in straight into the Zeus's arms.
He got his Radiance.
Well, that's, at least he's finished his Radiance. He should be able to back off. He has got his team around the corner. And there's... Oh, Invoker. Doesn't manage to save him, though, because Sankin comes in around the corner. And Invoker should die here as well. Taking... Oh, yeah, and he pays the price. Batrider, though, gets the ulti off, pulls the Tide up on the cliff. Rubik's there as well. So Tide will die for this, by the looks of it. He's just going to be focused down. The rest of the Radiant, I want to come round. There's the PA. Blinks down into the river, kills him.
Magic
and
stick.
Tide is still...
Always going for Batrider.
Oh,
he's still alive.
And he goes down.
The PA out of mana, but they don't have anything else. That's really, really good fight for PA. They could almost do Roche now if they're kind of cheeky.
Yeah, I think they should probably try it here. PA is just asking for the pings there, so they climb down off the cliff.
It's really basic. I don't think they're gonna do for Roche. It took too long. If they had someone in Roche, but they could just blink down and go for it. So they're actually PA is almost gonna get his BKB when Spectre has Radiance, so that's really good timing.
Yeah, and so Spectre was caught there under the tower. He haunted down to dodge himself dying under the tier 1 to over here, which was to the Zeus's arms. Nearly managed to get away if it wasn't for Sanking Blink, which caught him with the stun there. And after that happened, the PA managed to rotate around so quickly that he just caught the Invoker, and the fight went to hell right there.
Yeah.
So it was a bit of a shame that they weren't able to just let the Spectre die and just leave it. They took the Tide up on the cliff, but it took them way too long to finish the Tide. As you said, it was just a combination of the Tide having one charges as well as being that tanky.
They are doing Roche now, going forward.
That's very nice to see. Yeah, Venge with a medallion, as well as having the Forge Spirits there.
Radiant can't contest it. They really don't want to fight before PA gets the BKB.
No, that's very nice. Yeah. Right. Okay. So.
Right now, they have Aegis and they have Radiant, so they should really try to get some towers down.
Yeah. What do you think about the effectiveness of? Obviously, we see Bracer stacking for the Rubik and one on the Venge just for the. Oh, here we go. Spectre has ulti now. A Lion immediately kills the illusions there with the mana drain. So it's. Haunt being forced.
I guess he just scouted because maybe he was afraid of getting
yeah, they are pushing a tier 2 down bot on the Invoker, so I suppose they know that they're safe to do this, so they are going to get a free tier 2 for it. Not quite. There's the fortification used. We do see rotations around from the Tide now, but this should still be the tower going down.
Yeah.
Tide
Neko got his Neko tree, so they're looking to try to push and end this game now.
Yeah, try and get what they can. And Invoker goes pretty hard there. Meeble drop, catches the Tide. Tide very low. Got to go down there. Zeus uses his ulti as well. Zeus going to get caught out here. Yule's up. And there's the finger from Lion. Aegis used.
He's going to blink in. Go aggressive.
Yeah, and he gets the kill there. Lion should go down as well. There's the lasso used. Did hex off the Invoker, but the Invoker's ready to go for more. So Invoker gets a triple with the help of the Batrider there at the end.
They could go for at least a tower now.
Yeah, so
PA got a BKB now, so it's they're gonna have a pretty hard time killing her actually.
Kick Octopus doing a lot of work here now, having 152 last hits. He's top of the net worth for the whole game and on the Dire as well.
He's really playing Invoker well. I think I would guess it's one of the heroes who plays a lot.
Yeah, he's really just showing like how much utility he can have. Oh, the disarm's so nice onto the PA as well. He's used it well a lot of the fights. And PA's well wants to blink here and on here on the Rubik, and there's the crit. BKB now used. Holds it so he doesn't get the lift off.
Do
but
they have detection? Oh my god, no detection.
No detection. I believe there is detection on the Lion who isn't in this fight, so that is a shame to see. And Venge just got a TP out. Invoker's still just goes walking away.
They're going on Spectre now, and he doesn't have ulti up.
Spectre gets focused down, but here we go again. Tide gets the Ravage off. Spectre just managed to outrun it.
Double kill now easily.
Oh, that's nice.
PA's kind of spin out of control now.
PA PA, as you said, getting the kills here. Should be able to find the Batrider in a second if they... No, Blinks comes out. I didn't realize Blinks came out.
They can't keep losing the fights like this to PA. They don't really have any real good heroes to shut her down. Like, they can't damage her that much. They have Batrider with the Flaming Lasso, but she's going to be a real problem, and she's farming a lot right now.
So that fight recap, stuff like that, that's 1,000 gold going straight to the PA with the Spectre dying. I suppose Haunt wasn't used, so
they
hold the cooldown, but still. And the mid lane, here we go, Venge caught out, Yules comes out, Lion gets the stun off, but Rubick wants to go through for more, does have the stun available, so Lion was actually pretty ballsy there to come back out, but Hex onto the Batrider, blinks in, Zeus already is now being used, Sand King blinks in, gets the stun off on Rubick, and he goes down. Zeus just doing so much damage, and they're running rings around the Dire there in the mid lane, and it's only Batrider left standing.
It looks really bad for Dire right now. I think they should smoke up and try to get a pick off now. They really have to do something. Spectre, you know, he's good late game, but against PA with a BKB, like, his Radiance isn't gonna do anything against BKB, and BKB is actually a pretty good item against Spectre.
No, I agree. Is Spectre going for a Blade Mail now? He has got a Vitality booster just to make it a little bit tanky, but this could be an issue.
Yeah, it actually looks like he's going for Blade Mail.
What's your thoughts on this, with obviously the PA having a BKB already?
Yeah, I guess he wants to have a way to counter the PA, but it's not really going to work at all. If PA can just use BKB, and if BKB is on cooldown, he can just kind of ignore the Spectre and kill Dire while he uses Blade Mail.
No, very true. It is a case at the moment for the Dire of just avoid the PA's BKB or manage to get a nice Batrider initiation off, pick the PA off, and then take the fight off that. But...
So PA got his passion now. It's looking really ugly for the Dire right now. It's going to be a tough game for them.
There could be a clash up here top. There is Invoker here with the Batrider. And here we go. Batrider catches the Zeus. No Yule's available, but the Sand King, you missed his epi because of the Spectre's ulti. Invoker gets Tornado, catches on two. There's the disarm. Zeus is going to go down in 2 seconds. No, he has got Bolt Charges available. And there's PA. Zeus manages to live on like 10 HP. Yeah. But there we go. We see Sand King was caught here.
He's going back in.
That was a very nice blink. The dagger was just about to hit onto the Invoker, and he managed to dodge it.
Actually, a misplay from PA there. When you have blinked dagger and Phantom Strike off, you should pretty much always blink to the guy, because it's much harder to dodge with blink.
Yeah, it guarantees it, because there's no travel
if you dagger. If you dagger him when he has blink up, he's just gonna dodge it so easily.
True.
But again, Spectre dies, and it's really bad when, like, it's 2-for-2, I think, this fight. But Spectre is living, and Spectre is dying, and PA is actually living. So their main carry is just keep getting killed.
Yeah, the gold is still in the Dire's favour, but not by much. And the net worth has taken the lead on the PA, who's now 16k on the net worth. As you said, having a basher, the BKB is on... Let me just quickly check that. BKB is on 9 seconds, so it's not even that they've got the duration of the BKB on their side. And I think this really makes the Invoker struggle now.
Yeah.
And it could be in another clash here in the woods. Oh, here we go. Invoker, Yulzed up there by the Zeus. Lion's got to get impaled.
Nice
combo, but the Venge swap comes out. There's the Lion OE onto the Venge. Venge gets the stuff on the PA, but the last who comes out, Zeus pulled away from the fight, but it doesn't matter. PA wants to try and run down the Invoker, but this fight is all over the place. Lion trying to catch the Venge out. Venge just running around, making them waste their time, and I suppose this is the best way they could.
Spectre doesn't have ulti for 15 seconds, so.
Well, that's okay then, just having the Venge die, because someone was going to die there. So Venge managed to waste their time, head back towards the Radiant base, and just force them to kind of play hunt the Venge.
I think Lion was actually blocking a PA, so he couldn't get to Invoker. It was pretty funny. It was like 2 seconds because Lion was blocking him. It was unfortunate. But the PA is going to get his Abyssal now, and the only real hero they have that could maybe potentially kill him is Invoker. And Invoker needs the BKB to be off cooldown. So unless Invoker maybe gets MKB now or something, then
yeah, it's gonna be very hard.
They don't have any real answer to this PA. They have to rely on PA doing a misplay or something.
Yeah, like a waste of the BKB cooldown. They know that going into the fight is probably the best case. Batrider doesn't have Lasso for 8 seconds, so the tier one still stands mid, but it's still taking more damage. And this is gonna be hard for them. This is really gonna be difficult.
Yeah.
Roshan's gonna be up in a minute now, so
I think if Invoker I don't think he's going to use, but if he went it, he could maybe burst down the PA before he activates BKB. So he can do the Yules combo where he sends him up and then do the meatball thing and then just blow him away. It's just possible to do that before he activates BKB. But it looks like he maybe wants to save for Ganims or something, I'm not sure.
Yeah, that would be beautiful to see that. Just to completely destroy the PA before able to activate the BKB is so nice. But she could be caught here mid. Like, Batrider's lasso is available, but they do know that the Radiant team is right behind them, so it's a risk. But I think Hefgar on the Batrider wants to go for this. No, not quite.
It's kind of, if PA is soloing this tower and Batrider pulls him in, it could go kind of wrong because he's jumping in now.
BKB is used, so if they can just run around him, there's the lasso, pulls him back. Venge is there as well. We do see that the... Oh, no. Venge goes down, gets bashed. There's going to be the cleave, but PA is going down here and does die. SK used his ult, full duration epicenter, was on the Batrider, so he does get the Batrider kill. But as you said, they managed to take PA down.
Still 3-for-1. Invoker is still surviving, and I think... he's got BKB now. I think Invoker... Invoker is kind of the answer to PA. Like, Spectre is not going to do anything, but what Invoker did was that he waited for the PA BKB to run out and then just burst him down with his spells.
Yeah. And being able to get this... Oh, wait, Invoker wants to go in for more. Gets the Tornado into the AP. Catches on 2. Lion very low as well. But is it going to be enough? He's walking into 3, and this is a case of being super ballsy.
Wow.
Disarm on 2.
Oh, mechanism. No.
Lion able to get the auto attacks off. And
this guy...
He's calling Rolf.
He's really, he's trying to make some plays, and I kind of like his style.
No, I do like that. Sometimes you got to be ballsy, especially when the game could go either way. That could have easily gone a different direction, but yeah, very, very ballsy there for the Invoker to do that. I still like it, though.
I'm cheering for this Invoker this game.
Yeah, so. Batrider is right on top of the Tidehunter. Trying it. There we go. There's the lasso. Pulls it back in. They do have 3 people there. The stun comes out. Kraken shell used, but yeah, well, Kraken shell activated, so I should say, not used. But Spectre is in the mid lane as well. Wants to try and run down the Zeus, but I think he should be more careful and just farm up. And yeah, Lion having the blink now. We said about this earlier, and Zeus ult catches the kill onto Rubick, who's very low. And yours now on Spectre.
Here comes PA. Just being a beast with a blade mail.
That's an issue. The 4 stuff maybe helps him out, but not quite.
He's going for the Batrider as well.
Oh, this is not nice. Gets the bash off, and this is going to be a kill. Yeah. PA just comes up, respawns, runs down mid, says, how are you doing, and gets a double kill.
PA getting that boost now.
That is scary stuff.
That's, he's gonna kill it pretty much wherever he wants. They can still win a good fight because they have the Batrider and they can take him when his BKB is active. Rosh is actually up now, so they could also go for that.
And here we go, we do see SK caught out here. Venge stun does connect, and he's going to have to pay the price. Dust used, but he is dead. And PA goes down for the Venge. Yeah. Lion's here as well, blinks in, gets the Hex off, gets the Staff and Invoker, and this is going to be a double kill. There's the Lion, oh, there's the Abyssal, and Invoker does go down.
Damn.
All for a Sand King.
So this PA Battle Fury, it's a really risky thing, and they had a lot of problems in the early game. But right now, because he got it, he just has insane damage and really, really good farm.
Yeah, there's been a couple of fights as well where it's been close to getting a double kill. Like, off mid, I believe the PA jumped in on the Venge Spirit and nearly killed the Invoker just from the cleave alone. It was a close call, obviously, one or two more crits in the situation.
Now.
And yeah, Aegis got to be onto the PA there. And
PA
that's
gets
be
this Aegis, I think it's pretty much game.
Have they got any hope of trying to hold it?
Yeah, they can still win, but it's... I think they're at least probably going to lose a Rex. They're actually trying to defend the Rosh.
Haunt comes up, but there's the illusion to be clear. Batrider does pull the Tide away.
I'm not sure why he grabbed Tide.
Ravage being used on the top of the hill, and Batrider now dies. May have been a situation of they're all clumped up together, and he's just a little bit of panic when you go into the pit, and there's the Batrider called the GG there. Oh,
I'm sure
dear.
If it's just GG, or is this actually a real GG?
No,
not
true.
Sure if they want to end the game. So,
maybe a fake GG.
If he grabs... Batrider there. I mean, if Batrider grabbed PA. Are you here, Rust?
Yeah, sorry, can you still hear me? Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you. So if Batrider grabbed PA, then they could at least perhaps hope that Tide or something would take the Aegis.
I agree. Forcing the... Well, I suppose PA would have still had the Blink Strike available. And here we go, Invoker again caught out here mid. this is what happens when you got the double blink dagger, but Invoker brought back, so at least he wants to try and do so. I guess this is the kind of, well, we're going to lose anyway, so we might as well go for some play, and Invoker wants to try and make something now. Psyking sound here in the trees. They do know he's here because of the Ghost War. And Lion being focused down here. Invoker pops his BKB as well. So the ult was used on, I believe, the Necro Creep. And yeah, Venge goes down. PA used the BKB. Trust running around here. Kills the Rubik as well. There is a Lasso available, but it pulls him back.
Lasso is not going to do anything.
No, Spectre's here as well. But
he can just, can perhaps still man fight.
Again, yeah, as you said, nothing really happened. So that's the Aegis.
But he managed to lose now and they haven't got Rex. So that's a decent fight.
There is no BKB available. Invoker's going in hard. Tries to kill the PA. PA's trying to run now. There's the stun from the... well, the stolen Slain King stun on the Rubik. And she goes to leap away. And this is where the Avenger comes into it. The Epicenter catch on three! Well, gets the double kill there. That's the buyback. And Batrider has to run away. They were baited in by a very, very low health Phantom Assassin. And...
The Mega actually missed the Phantom Assassin. But,
yeah. Oh, there's the Horn. Comes through. Catches up. And he tried to go onto the PA, obviously thinking she was still low, but this is what happens when you just life still up in the jungle.
Yeah,
and now PA is
going to
touch
Spet. Oh
dear, Spet's just sitting on the cliff. He's ready to TP out in 2 seconds, but Sand King wants to come for him. They know he's up here, but they don't go for him. No blink on stun, so okay, well, Spet gets away.
Sand King is afraid. Okay, here comes the stun, but too late. So, I think the blade mail pick off on Spetsa is... it's not really gonna do anything. And he tried to rush Radiance, but then got killed once and then got Treads and Urn. If he just got straight Treads and Urn, and actually, he could actually like hold the enemy team down a lot. But now, right now, it's just too late.
Yeah, Bissell being used on him mid, and the PA's actually used BKB and backed off again. Lasso is available. Will they go in on the PA? No, okay, they just back out. But yeah, well, do you think if the Spectre was given a little bit more space, finished off his Radiance, and then still went the Naked Radiance, it would have paid off there? Or do you think that it's, generally speaking, better to get the... oh, that was a nice swap there, just as the PA jumps in, but too late. There comes the Ravage, catches on two. Batrider gets caught as well, very low. There's the dagger. Is that dagger going to be a
maybe.
Crit? No.
Okay, that's the dagger. Well, I think maybe even if you have like a trial and you have free farm, you're not gonna have it for 15 minutes. You're not gonna have it 15 minutes without a gank. So I think you should probably always at least get a urn before, because then you can actually tank the, what the enemy throws at you.
And yeah, no, I agree. It gives you a lot more utility, as you said, because you could grab some charges from obviously using your horn and being able to come around. Then you could go into the jungle, then heal yourself up with the urn. And oh, here we go. Spectre getting caught out. There's the epicenter. There's the dagger. The blade bell's used, but too late. Even Sanky's got a BKB now. Lasso trying to pull him into the pool desperately. Sanky's brought back. Sanky's brought back. Sorry, Spectre's brought back. But he's able to back out now.
What a crit.
And that's the crit.
So they really needed to punish this greedy Phantom Assassin build. Going for rushing Battle Fury and Face Boots. He's so easy to kill in the beginning.
Yeah, it's hard to say that. Who would you say, obviously for the Dire, I think we have to give MVP to the Invoker. He's made some pretty big plays here. Barrett has got some catches as well, but it feels like there hasn't been enough follow-up sometimes, but I suppose that could happen with a little bit of miscommunication. Some people going in, some people backing out. It could lead to your initiation and perfect catch turning into you blinking into your own feed. And but it's a risky one.
I think PA, I don't agree with her item choices, but she had really solid play on the Radiant.
Again, we see another Horn come through. Blamer being activated, kills the Zeus, but there's a bash. PA's just chasing down the Spectres, doesn't get the kill. Lasso used, and Sand King should die, but there's the finger on the Spectre. PA still standing, there's a crit. Venge trying to back out, swaps the Batrider, and she's like, I don't want to die. And that's a double.
Jesus.
Last one sides the Rubik, and I still think one of them on the Dire is just cancelled the GG. He's like, you know what, we'll keep going. But that's a five-man wipe. Is there going to be a proper GG call now, or are they just going to wait for the tier 4? No. Looks like they're going to have to end the game. Well, that's fair enough.
But Spectre, he could punish the PA actually a lot. Like, if one person just goes for the try to gank PA, Spectre can just go in with Urn and just haunt, and he only has 20% evasion in the beginning, so Spectre could do a lot of stuff keeping PA down, but instead he just went greedy and just tried to farm as well, and the PA just ended up working much better for him.
No, I agree. I do like this Invoker just doing the ballsy plays. He knows the game's over, so he's just running around doing what he can.
He's doing it for us.
Yeah. just gotta try and keep the entertainment factor up at the last second. But no. Yeah, so, like, at no point did it feel out of anyone's hands, so it could have been, as you said, a case of a bit too much greed on one side and not enough push from the other. But yeah, good game.
Yeah, it was a good game. It was pretty nice to see. I'm glad that he actually, after he got ganked first, he actually went back for the rim and trades, but I think he should have been more active on the map.